thanks for tuning in another Fast Fix here. This one's going to deal with any of the ES or RS JLG electric scissors. The code is going to be a 7742. That's improper field voltage. Don't let that panic you. It's actually pretty simple, not overly complicated. And I can show you how to make the machine operate again without buying any components if you're stuck in a jam and need to get the machine moved immediately. So follow along. I will explain how this system works first to help simplify maybe the process, but I'm going to draw you a little diagram here. Just hang on a second.
I'll give you the quick recap here. That code 7742 is relating to the motors and the field windings of the motors. The power module, which is actually named a Zappy. I don't come up with this stuff. That's what it's called. What's happening when it's setting this code, this, when you power on the machine, the Zappy turns on, it sends out a test signal out here and wants to see it come back. F1 and F2 terminals on the Zappy are labeled. They'll actually, both wires will be blue. This is an illustration. I've used blue to kind of help simplify that. But what happens is when that signal doesn't make it back because of some kind of a fault, it'll set this code. Okay, well then of course it disables any function from the machine. You can power it on, won't lift, won't drive, it does nothing. So if you're stuck and you gotta get this thing moved quick, well, follow along here and I'll show you how to make the machine operate on just one motor if that's the case. So what you can do to test it, like we've already discovered, well, the signal's not getting back. So our telephone line, wire, whatever you want to call it in your mind to understand what's happening, has a break in it. It's either got an open, illustrated like this, signal can't get through, or we have an issue with one of the motors, or the wiring is actually shorted to the machine. So essentially you have a short to ground, is what they kind of call that. And there's a couple ways you can test that. The first thing I would do though is isolate the motors. On the orange wire coming out of the motors, they're tied together in series. There's actually a little black plastic plug where these are hooked together. Unplug it there. So we'll illustrate that by this here. So go ahead and remove the terminals F1 and F2. I'd probably label them. That way you can keep which one where it goes. And then take your meter. Check continuity between the orange and the blue wire. Should be relatively low resistance, about an ohm-ish or less is probably acceptable. Now, it doesn't guarantee the motor is good because it could be the wiring or the motor might be shorted somewhere, shorted to ground or another circuit. So I'll do the same thing. I'll take 1 meter lead here and then touch it to the motor case, some kind of bare spot. Should be infinite or mega ohms or extremely high amount of resistance. That means it has no continuity. At that point, that motor checks fine. Do the same thing to the motor two. Put your meter lead where the wire come off at F2. Go to here where the orange plug was at. Do the same thing. If you discover inside the motor is infinite resistance, well then say if motor two is the bad motor, well, that's pretty simple. All we need to do is a series circuit from F1 to F2 on one motor and it will work. So I can illustrate it like this. Hook F1 back into motor one and then F2, the orange wire, we're gonna leave motor two out of the circuit. You literally just take that thing, tie it into this. Now that might require putting a loop end on a wire or make a jump wire, or if this motor's junk, cut the wires and put your splice on it and then hook it up. And I will guarantee you, as long as you got that right, it will run on one motor in drive and operate relatively well. Now that's if you have a meter. Now let's say you don't have a meter, code 7742, 99% of the time, one of these motors or the wiring has failed. So you can still do the same procedure. Let's say motor one. Take motor one blue wire, leave it in place, and then take this motor out, put it on F2. Power on the machine, still have code 7742, and no big deal. Reverse it. Take motor one out of the equation, and go ahead and wire in motor two. So, well, originally, motor two, the blue wire was on F2, so we'll restore that and do this. Power on the machine, you got no more fault code 7742. Hey, not only have you diagnosed the problem that something is wrong in motor one, you can drive the machine again. So, if that gets you the answers you need, great. I've actually, if you continue to watch, I got some live footage of actually on the machine to help maybe if you need to visualize it, if that helps you out. But the biggest thing with this code is typically it's a failed motor or wiring, and most time it's inside the motor. And this, if you're wiring one motor, it'll get you by in the meantime. I hope this helps out. This is a little longer demonstration I normally want to do, but you're going to find this is a super common problem. And maybe this will help you in a pinch get the machine moved, at least mobile again, until you get the parts to get it fixed up. So if you don't continue watching to the end here, no big deal. Thanks for checking it out. Of course, anything else I can help you with, shoot me a message. See if I can maybe point you in the right direction. Again, thanks for your time. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time.
Now that class time is over, what will happen is if yours has this little display, you can actually see when you power it up here. You'll get a code here that says 7742. Again, don't let that panic you. Improper fuel voltage doesn't mean the end of the world. Like I said, I'm going to show you how to make the machine work again. But to diagnose it, we need to go up here to the front of the machine. At the front of the machine, here is the Sevcon power module, Zappy, I guess, found the world you live in. It's underneath this cover. Remove the bolt out of the top, which I've already done. And then behind it is our power module. Now, the parts in question, as I showed in the diagram, F1 and F2 terminals are here on the side. That's the beginning and the end of our field voltage circuit. So what we're going to do is either we've got a bad drive motor here, or maybe even the wiring to and from might be damaged. So I'm going to show you how to do that here with a meter, how to test that, and then I'll show you how to make it work again. First off, let's just start, we'll call this motor one, or left side motor. Now the harness comes here, down to the machine, down into here. This is the harness. Now, look on this harness, you will find a blue and an orange wire. Now I got it here in my hand. This is the field wires for this motor. And you can do the same for the other side. The motor tracing around, you come down here. Inside, you will find, again, a blue and an orange wire. You will see here in my hand the orange wires. There's a jumper in them. Interesting. I showed that in the diagram. Like I said, both these motors are hooked in series. So with that being said, here's the, I guess, the secret to the end of this one is if the motors are hooked in series and one is bad, well, eliminate the one bad motor. Then you can actually operate on whichever one is still good. The machine will actually perform relatively well. At least good enough to get you by until you get your replacement harness or motor, whatever the ailment ends up being. But I'm gonna show you a quick way to test that. But right here, this jumper in my hand, like I said, you can unplug it, and that then isolates the motors left and right. All right, so let's test out the left motor here first. What you will see, we're gonna take the leads. I got one probed into the plug there. I'm gonna take the old alligator clip here on the other one. I've already removed a little torch bit and remove the wire from the power module here. So we're gonna put the clamp on that. Now this should have relatively low resistance, probably less than 1 ohm or so. Okay, again, basically nothing. And that's what I expect to see on a good windings or a good motor. So I'm gonna say this motor is probably good, but there's one more thing to check before we can say this one's got a clean bill of health and the wiring is good. I wanna make sure the wiring harness isn't shorted or contacting back to the case. You have either a situation where the motor is open or shorted. So now what we're going to do now is take, leave that one still hooked to that, and then we're going to take the old clip here and put it on the motor case and see what the reads. It should read the same thing, infinite resistance or open, or mega ohms, depending on how sensitive your meter is. There's a chance it might pick it up, but at this point, I'm going to say this motor and wiring is intact. So I don't think our problem is this side of it. Going to have to be this motor here. So you do the same procedure for this motor. You're going to find that either the windings are open or it's shorted. So let's do the same thing for this side. We're probably going to find that this one is our issue. We're going to repeat the same process for the other side, but I'm not going to probably go as slow, but just I'll remove the wire here off of it. Just one little torch head bolt. Okay, now it's out of the way. Now I have my blue wire free, and then here's my orange wires. Now we're going to do the same thing. Check these wires, should have continuity across them. And if it does, well, then maybe a shorted motor. So I'm going to clamp the one end on here, and we're going to probe the other end. Doing here, trying to probe it here again, but this is kind of what I expected to see, the one with an open windings or open field windings. So I'm going to say our problem is that motor. Now I also said I'm going to show you how to make it operate with just one motor. So, we've already removed this F2 terminal wire off, which goes, I'm going to call it the right side motor. Now, we've made up jumpers, but you can either make up a jumper, like we have here. You see it plugs into our jumper wire. And then hook her back on the F2. Okay, so we're just going to make a complete circuit again as the goal. Or if the motor's already been determined junk, you can do the same procedure. Just cut the wire and put a butt splice in it and make it go to get you going again. But I'm going to put this little jumper in here and show you this thing actually will run on one motor. It really doesn't hurt a thing. Close up here, you'll see a blue wire is not hooked up. That's perfectly fine. That's for motor two or the right side motor. So if you pull this harness up here, one coming down to that motor, trace the wires, you'll see the blue wire for this motor is hooked to one terminal, and the orange wire for this motor is hooked to the other terminal. It's F1 and F2. Now we're going to run on just this motor. And just a little fun fact. It doesn't matter the location, sort of, meaning it's not going to hurt it, but it will change the direction of drive if you get this backwards. You grab a handful of drive controller and it goes forward, well, you get the wires reversed. Flip-flop the wires and it will restore the correct direction. But since it only took the one off, blue's still in the same spot, and I put the orange on, it should drive correct in the right direction. And I also should be relieved of code 7742. As you can see, I don't have any fault codes displaying on the display, so when I flip it to platform, you should have drive. There you have it. Let me get one more thing to keep in mind here before we go to the conclusion here. The motors themselves typically end up being the failure. So let's say you don't have a meter, but you do see that code 7742. It won't hurt anything to even just try isolate left motor, try it around the SevCon, power it up. Doesn't operate, no big deal. Isolate the right motor, hook it up to the SevCon, and if it does take off and operate, well then there you go. You know you have a left side motor or harness problem. So this can be done without a meter. You're just gonna have to, you know, move some wires around and try it once or twice. I guess you could trial and error kind of thing, and then see if code 7742 goes away. So that'd be one more way you could do without a meter or getting too carried away. Just keep that in mind. Well, there you have it in a nutshell. Code 7742, not overly complicated. We're just making a series circuit with one motor instead of two to make it operate. Hope that works out. The diagram at the beginning of the video, probably write that down, doodle it, draw it down, or just watch the video again. I'll show you what we've actually done to make it go. But this, I say this happened pretty frequently, this failure, and this is how we get the machines to move. Let's say you're stuck in the middle of a hallway or in the side of someone's business office and they want it moved right now, and you don't have time for a motor, don't have time to get a wiring harness. What do? Well, you do this little fix here, it'll get you by and get you moving down the road. So, I guess, thanks again for watching. I'll keep posting these things up here. Any more problems, questions, concerns, or maybe an issue you've had, I might have the solution. So, hit me up. Email link is on the description of the video. Shoot it my way, and I'll see if I can help you out with that. But, thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time. This doesn't happen without you watching this. If you could, please subscribe. Keep me going. Like I said, send me some more information on what you have. Maybe I've got the solution. Thanks again for watching.